Hello everyone. In this PowerPoint, I am going to explain you about the stability studies for finished drug products. Myself, Dr. Nagadani Spanalata, Department of Pharmaceutics. The outline of this presentation includes all these contents, like from definition to the conclusion. So before going to learn about how to conduct the stability studies and how to perform the stability testing of finished pharmaceutical products, we must be aware about what do you mean by stability. So what is stability? So stability is nothing but the stability of any pharmaceutical product may be defined as the capability of a particular formulation in a specific container or closure system. So the stability of any product may be defined in terms of its capacity, in terms of its capability to sustain its stability within its physical, chemical and microbiological, therapeutic and toxicological specifications over the period of time during the storage conditions. So stability is nothing but it has to maintain different properties of a formulation which are enclosed in a container or closure system. So in simple terms, we can also tell stability as it is a measure of how pharmaceutical products maintains its quality attribute over a time. So in simple sentence, stability can also be defined as it is a measure of how any pharmaceutical product will maintain its quality attribute over a period of time. So finally, stability is nothing but it is defined as the capacity or capability of any pharmaceutical product to maintain its standards in regards of any physical, chemical, microbiological, biological, etc. over a period of time. That is called as stability. Next, stability study. So stability study or stability testing is a very complex process. Why? Because this process will include a variety of factors. Those factors are stability of the API, container closure system used for packaging, heat and moisture conditions encountered during travel or during storage or during handling, type of dosage form and interaction between the API and excipients. So stability study, doing the stability study or doing the stability testing will be a complex process. Why? Because it is involved with a variety of factors. So these are different factors. We need to test the stability of the API and we need to test the container or closure system which is used for packaging. And we need to understand how the heat and moisture conditions during the travel and storage and handling will affect the stability. And get to assess the type of dosage form, and we need to assess the interaction. Is there any possible interaction between the API and the excipients? As the stability study involves all these factors, hence it is called as a complex process. What are the main objectives of stability study? So for what purpose we are doing the stability study? The different objectives are to provide evidence on how the quality of drug substance varies with the time under the influence of different environmental factors. The main purpose of doing the stability study is to assess, to evaluate how any drug substance or how any formulated products will varies with the time when it is stored under different environmental factors. Like what are different environmental factors for a drug to get exposed? Probably the temperature, humidity and light, and to establish retest period for drug substances. If needed, we need to establish a retest period for drug substances. So to establish this retest period also, stability study must be performed. And to establish shelf life for finished products and to determine its expiry date. The main mode of stability testing is to give a shelf life or to give an expiry date to a product. That is the main motto of stability testing. And in the subsequent slides, I will tell you how to determine the shelf life also. To determine the storage conditions required to be maintained. So we can't keep all type of dosage forms under the same conditions, same temperature, same humidity, etc. Some substances need to be protected from temperature and some substances need to be protected from moisture, etc. So how we can know at what temperature and what humidity conditions this should be exposed? This can be understood only when we perform the stability testing and to determine the physical and chemical properties of the drug. So before going to conduct the stability testing, one must be aware about what are the different physical and chemical properties of the drug, like melting point, etc., boiling point. So if one are aware about the physical and chemical properties of a drug molecule, then we can assess at what conditions the product will be stable. To identify the decomposed products, obviously, to identify whether any decomposed products are there in the formulation also, you need to conduct the stability testing. And to determine the changes to be made in the chemical structure of a drug, sometimes to avoid the instability of a drug, we need to make slight changes, molecular changes in the chemical structure of a drug. So that is also a main objective of stability testing, and to facilitate development of the most stable dosage form. The final goal is to achieve the most stable dosage form, or most stable and most effective dosage form from the stability testing. So these are the different objectives of stability testing. What is the scope of stability testing? So the scope is to provide evidence as to how the quality of drug product varies with time. So the main scope of stability testing is to provide a proof, like how the quality of the drug product will varies as the time goes on. And as we discussed in the previous slide, the main scope also includes to establish the shelf life or expiry date for the drug product, and to determine the possible recommended storage conditions, that means at what temperature and what humidity conditions, whether the drug substance is allowed to expose to the sunlight, etc. All these conditions should be determined. And to determine the effective container and closure system. And it has to be in view of safety point of patient. So all these comes under scope of stability testing. What is the rationale of stability testing? The chemical degradation of the product leads to the lowering of concentration of drug in the dosage form. For suppose if the product is not stable, so it was suspected for chemical degradation. So what will happen? If the product will got chemically degraded, obviously the toxic product will be formed. So because of the toxic products, there may be toxicity to the body even, right? So chemical degradation of a product leads to the lowering of the concentration of the drug in the dosage form, and it will also lead to the formation of toxic products. And instability of the drug product may reduce the bioavailability. So what is bioavailability? The amount of drug that reaches the systemic circulation is called as bioavailability. If the drug product is found to be unstable, it may have its effect on bioavailability. The bioavailability of the drug will get reduced. And instability of a product may change the complete physical appearance of a product. If the physical appearance of the product will change, the elegance of the product will be decreased. And finally, the consumer acceptance also will be decreased. So if any chemical degradation of a product led to the decrease in the concentration of a dose of drug in the dosage form, because of which the toxic products may evolve, which will be toxic to the body, and it may have the reduction in the bioavailability, and the total physical appearance of the product will be decreased. So what is the ultimate achievement of stability studies? So what after doing stability studies, what you are giving assurance in what terms it is effective? So it has the ultimate achievement is to provide 100% assurance to the patient who is taking the treatment that the patient is under the right treatment, and to consider economically. So economic considerations also should be kept in mind, and legal requirements. All the stability studies should meet the legal requirements, so which are approved by some regulatory bodies. These are the ultimate achievement of stability studies, which are including assurance to the patient, economic considerations, and legal requirement. So what are the possible adverse effects of instability of drug products? First one will be loss of active drug. So So there may be complete loss of API from the formulation. So because of which there won't be any therapeutic action to the patient. So examples include aspirin hydrolysis. Aspirin, when it comes in contact with the water, it will undergo a reaction called hydrolysis, because of which the active ingredient will be lost. And loss of vehicle. Sometimes, especially while formulating the creams, which are especially oil in water type of emulsion creams, in that conditions, there may be possibility of evaporation of water from those creams and loss of content uniformity. So example comes under examples is creaming of emulsions. If there is any creaming occurs in the emulsion and then there is any impaction occur in the suspension, the content uniformity will be less. The dose will not be properly distributed. Loss of elegance, example fading of tablets and colored solutions. So upon aging, sometimes what will happen, the tablets, especially the colored tablets, will undergo fading and the colored solutions too. So it causes a loss of elegance to the product. So obviously the consumer acceptance will be decreased and reduction in bioavailability. So example, aging of tablets results in a change in the dissolution profile. So due to the instability of a drug product, what will happen? For suppose if you take the tablets for instance, it will result in the change in dissolution profile. If there is a change in dissolution profile, for suppose the drug need to be released for 10 minutes, for 10 minutes it need to be released 50% of the drug. But because of the aging of the tablet, sometimes it is not able to achieve that percentage for the proposed time intervals. In that condition, there may be reduction in the bioavailability and production of potential toxic materials. Same as we discussed in the previous slides, if you take an example of chemical degradation, so because of the types of degradation, breakdown products will form. Because of the breakdown products, these products will be toxic. These products will be toxic. So these are the different adverse effects of instability of drug products. So now, what are the environmental factors which contributes towards the drug instability? So what factors will make the drug or drug product to be unstable? Those are temperature, moisture, and light. We'll discuss about one by one. First, we go for temperature. So always keep in mind, higher the temperature, higher will be the rate of degradation. So high temperature accelerate the reactions called oxidation, reduction, and hydrolysis, which will lead to drug degradation. So if the temperature keeps on increasing, it may accelerate some different reactions like oxidation, reduction, and hydrolysis, which in turn causes drug degradation. So what are the different types of storage temperatures? So these are the standard storage temperatures, like room temperature, as all we know, it is about 25 degrees centigrade. Cool temperature means the temperatures between 8 to 20 degrees centigrade. Cold or refrigerator storage conditions means 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. Freeze storage, which is between minus 20 to minus 10 degrees centigrade. Next, light. So light also plays an important role in the degradation of the drug or drug products. The term is called as photolysis. That means decomposition of the product in presence of light is called as photolysis. Here, one point is important. Shorter the wavelength, more the energy will be absorbed per mole. If the light source is having the shorter wavelength, more the energy will be absorbed. What are the various sources of light? Sunlight, metal halide lamps, fluorescent lamps, or other indoor lighting sources. So these reactions can be induced by exposure to photolysis sources emitting in the range of 290 to 800 nanometer region. So decomposition of a product in presence of light is called as photolysis. So as I told in the previous slide, there is a relationship between the wavelength and the associated energy of various forms of light. Here, I am taking three types of radiations: UV, visible, IR radiations. UV, the wavelength is 500 to 400 nanometers. For visible, it is 400 to 750 nanometers. For IR, it is 750 to 10,000 nanometers. And here, these are the values of energy absorbed per kilo mole. So what I told in the previous slide is, shorter the wavelength, higher will be the energy absorbed. In all these types of radiations, UV radiations having the low or short wavelength, because of which more amount of energy will be absorbed. How we can prevent the photolysis? Photolysis can be prevented by packing the product in an amber colored bottles. So these amber colored bottles has the capacity to resist the light source, and to pack in cardboard outers and to wrap in aluminum foil. So these three parameters will prevent the drug to get decomposed in the presence of light. So moisture is another parameter. So because of the moisture, hydrolytic degradation will be enhanced, and we can protect the products away from the moisture when we can pack the contents in a glass or plastic containers to protect the drug product under high humidity conditions. So in this part 1 PowerPoint, I have discussed about what is the stability, the definition, the objectives of stability testing, and what are the adverse effects of stability testing, scope of stability testing, and what are the environmental factors that may affect the drug stability. The rest of the matter will be covered in part 2.